this ride of my life was about to come up. A truck with a fat boy on the back, with about six or seven boys sprawled on it, and the drivers, two young blonde farmers from Minnesota, were picking up every single soul they found on that road. The most smiling, cheerful couple of handsome bumpkins I could ever wish to see. Both wearing cotton shirts and overalls, nothing else. Both thick-wristed and earnest, with broad, hilarious smiles for anybody and anything that came across their path. I went up and said, "Is there room?" They said, "Sure, hop on. There's room for everybody." I wasn't down the flat board before the truck rolled off. I lurched, a rider grabbed me, and I sat down. Somebody passed me a bottle of vodka, the bottom of it. I took a big swig in the wild, lyrical, dazzling air of Nebraska. "Whoa, here we go!" yelled a kid in a baseball cap. And they opened up the truck to 70 and passed everybody on the road. "We've been riding this sun that they've seen me on. These guys never stop. Every now and then you have to get off a biscuit or otherwise you have to piss off the air. And you ain't going, brother. Hang on." I looked at the company. There were two young farmer boys from North Dakota who wore baseball caps, which is the standard North Dakota farmer boy cap, and they were headed for the harvest. There were men that came to me to hit the road for the summer. There were two young city boys from Columbus, Ohio. High school football players, chewing gum, winking, singing in the breeze, and sadly hitchhiking around the United States in the summer. "We're going to L.A.," they yelled. "What are you going to do there?" "Hell, we don't know. Who cares?" Then there was a tall, slim fellow who had a sneaky look. "Where are you from?" he asked. I was lying next to him on the platform. You couldn't sit without bouncing off. You had no wheels. And he turned slowly to me, opened his mouth, and said, "Montana." Finally, there were Mississippi Gene in his charge. Mississippi Gene was a little dark guy who rode freight trains around the country, a 30-year-old hobo, but with a youthful look, so he couldn't tell exactly what his age was. And he sat on the board's cross-legged, looking out over the fields without seeing anything for hundreds of miles. And finally, at one point, he turned to me and said, "Where are you headed?" I said, "Denver. I've got a sister there, but I haven't seen her for over years." His charge was a 16-year-old tall blonde kid, also in hobo rags. That is to say, he wore old clothes that had been turned black on his soot of railroads with the dirt of boxcars and sleeping on the ground. The blonde kid was also quiet. He seemed to be running away from something. He had given to me the law, the way he looked straight ahead and wet his lips